Rapid and Blitz.
Here we can see that players started the clock and made the first moves. On the first board, we have e4, c5, and a3.
A3, right. That's a change of attitude for the Blitz. Magnus has played well. It's a peculiar line, I have to say. So, sacrificing a pawn that early in the game. Kiev seems to be ready for this scenario. He plays pretty fast. So, what do we have here? It's like knight a3, playing very fast. That's, well, not the most usual line, I have to say.
But yes.
I think if black does that, and well, actually after second move a3, the move which was played in our game, I think g6 is a recommended move for black, because if black does all that, I think white is kind of happy. He gets what he wants. He sacrifices.
He gets these two files, AB files, and also a very stable center.
And, well, the leading development is also one very important thing, because at the moment it looks like black is even better developed, but white will win some tempi for sure.
Yeah, because of this queen on d5,
is never good
in the center.
Some knight b5 moves are possible, threatening knight c7. Bishop f5 played by Inar Kiev. Well, knight b5 is a possibility to threaten the fork on c7. He can also start developing, just like knight f3, and he will win those tempi later
c4.
On.
Yeah.
Knight f3 to start with, then bishop c4with a tempi, knight b5. Well,
knight b5. He simply wants to fork on c7.
Yeah, well, that's
and
an
like
attempt
to... forced to play rook c8.
Yeah, but this is an attempt to kind of win immediately by Magnus Carlsen, right? Knight b5, but he needs a real follow-up to this one, which I'm not sure he has.
Now this a-pawn on a7 is poison, probably, because rook can come back on
e8. You mean if the knight takes on a7, rook a8, knight can come back to b5 as well. But yeah, it's a tricky situation. I don't think his plan is to take the pawn, honestly.
Yes.
I don't think his plan is to take the pawn. Some bishop e3, maybe. Or
maybe some check first from e4, and then the same scenario.
You mean for black? Well, Magnus has started to think that early in the game. Yeah, once again, I have to say this. It's really, really tough for the players. It will be tough for the players, especially in the first rounds, to readjust from playing
from
the rapid
yesterday.
From yesterday. And especially when they get to play on increment, because the increment is no longer 10 seconds, but only 2.
And this time control is really tricky. 2 seconds, you have increment, but still it's really not big time.
Yeah, well, on one hand, you cannot really lose on time if you have like simple winning positions. So you should be able to mate with an extra rook, so that's
it actually takes.
Now we'll see. I mean, rook a8, at least white had, not b5. I guess that's the whole point. Comes back to b5, if queen e4 check, bishop e3, and the rook is protected. I think that's the point Magnus Carlsen tries to make. Well, what I'm worried about a bit more, if black simply takes on a7, rook a7, and then starts to develop, because in this case, black actually will be better developed. It's like knight takes a7, he'll take with the rook, and then some knight f6, or e6 to start with. And
I'm really surprised to take on e7, even if it was the first what came to my mind.
Yeah, look, he's also down to 1 minute 14, which is, well, you expect players to have a little bit more time if you're talking about the blitz and only 10th move for white. So it's move number 10, knight a7, he has used 2/3 of his time for this game. But now it's in Kiev's turn to think. So maybe that will be...
They were about to equal the time now.
Yeah, that's equal. That will be, I guess, Magnus's policy for this tournament. So play in balanced position, try to put some pressure right from the start. Some unusual openings I think we will see some unusual openings from the world champion. Well, as to... If you want to speak about the favorites, it's really, really tough to mention. I mean, who is the favorite in this tournament? The obvious reply is the top seed Magnus Carlsen, but you have the current world blitz champion Kerviakin in the field. You have Maxim Vashiela-Grav, who is known to be terribly strong in blitz, The shorter the time control is, the better Maxim Vyshyelegrov chances do. Well, on board two, we have Levon Aronian, who won a very strong event in St. Louis, I think, in Blitz with all those guys playing.
Yeah. Karjakin is number three by rating.
Yeah, so
by rating, and Vashe follows Dingli Ren.
And Ivanchuk is very high.
Yeah.
That's interesting. I've announced that Artemiev is very high on the list. Well, not number two, but number eight.
Artemiev is on number eight. Top ten.
Okay, we've missed a few moves. And look, you know, Kiev is down to 18 seconds only. So an exchange on e7 happened. Then, you know, Kiev has played
e5. Yes.
Opening the center. Magnus went with knight f3. Exchange on d4. And now bishop d7. Prophylactical move against bishop b5 check.
Mm-hmm.
So White's problem is...
It's very hard to develop this bishop from f1 and castle,
because the bishop from
g2 pawn is hanging.
It's not that easy to develop. I mean, he might even win bishop e2 still. Mm-hmm. Bishop e2 was the point that if queen takes on g2, it's bishop f3. Knight b5.
Knight goes on b5. Now so another knight goes.
It's a second knight on b5 in this game.
Queen exchange.
Queen exchanged, and we get some endgame.
Now this bishop press on g2,
but... Bishop d3 is the good move, I guess.
Bishop c5
attacking the rook on a7. Now it's the moment you want to give a check, right, and see where the king is going. After knight e7...
Now rook is hanging, rook has...
Rook is still here. Bishop a3, brilliant move.
Wow.
Bishop a3, rook d8. Brilliant move, but white is still not very...
Knight on d4 is a very nice square for knight.
He's comfortable now, yeah. King c2, but so is in Arkiv's position, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
So is in Arkiv's position, I would say. Ah, well, rook a7, so now if the pawn on g2 is hanging, if the pawn
is
taken...
Yeah, f3 probably.
Probably f3, right. Rook e8,
also
rook
g1 was a possible...
Rook e8, practical decision.
The black position is already down down to 6 seconds. It's a very short time.
The position is roughly equal, but now, the time is the major factor. Rook to b8. Yeah, and in blitz, you know, you don't want to take on c6. You prefer knights over bishops, that's I'm sure. No, he takes because it was a blunder. Now on king c6,
there
is bishop
b5
check. King b6. It's not that... Rook takes b7 is a possibility. Well, white wins the... Yeah, rook takes b7. White wins a pawn like this. It's an illegal move, knight e3. It's an... That's incredible. What has happened?
It costs him less in this case.
I'm not sure.
It's really, totally illegal.
Kiev played an illegal move.
Kasim should stop the clock. If he plays another move, that means it's illegal.
Really?
Yeah, he lost.
Really?
Yes.
So now Kiev won the game like this, you mean?
Yes, I think.
That's incredible.
Oh my God.
That's really incredible.
Yes.
I mean, this is... But how is it possible? I mean, you make an illegal move and you win.
It's double illegal move.
Something with rules of chess. I'm sorry for that, but really this... The commission who makes those rules, I mean, they have to work out on this one, because you are not supposed to win a game by making illegal moves.
Yeah, it's...